Hello students, welcome back. Students, understanding the liberalization process and eventually turned up with the privatization process, today we are here to understand, to learn globalization. Now the word globalization we will first understand. Globalization comes from the word globe, globe as in whole earth. And since it is economics chapter and not a geography chapter, here in the globe, all the economies are considered. So each economy of the world, each country is linked with another economy. This process is known as globalization. Here there is a definition given. The process of connecting one country's economy with the world economy is known as globalization. There are some improvements done. What earlier it was and what it is now, there are some improvements done after 1991 globalization policy. The first is obstacles of the trade between the two nations has been removed. No country will deny for any product of other country getting into the country. So the obstacles, the barriers, they are removed. Second, such a condition has been created that capital exchange can take place. Capital here in economics is not only money. Capital means all the physical goods, the technology. It can be exchanged. As in, the restrictions of importing technology and exporting technology is removed. And third, free exchange of labor. Now see, every country is not blessed with a good manpower. And those countries where there is less of manpower, it is very expensive manpower due to imbalance of demand and supply. So globalization has enabled, has motivated, has boosted, has pushed the labor exchange also. So any person from any country can go to some other country to work. Here labor does not mean physical labor only. For example, the chartered accountants of India get placed to work for a company in Dubai. So that chartered accountant is also termed as labor. Labor means any person who is getting paid for doing either physical or mental work or maybe both. So the barriers are removed, the capital exchange is possible and labor exchange. So these changes are made. Then comes advantages. Now what good things happened when globalization took place? First, the FDI is encouraged, foreign direct investment. Some countries person can invest in Indian company. That is, some foreigner can directly invest in India. So person in US can invest certain dollars in Indian business. So that is, FDI is encouraged. Goods produced around the globe can be received. We wear all the brand clothes. We wear multi-brand shoes, which is not manufactured in India, but we still wear it. So that is because of globalization. All the countries, they can share their goods very easily. Developing countries like India can have a wider market. Say, suppose I'm manufacturing a mobile phone and in India, I have a limited market, as in limited people liking my phone or wanting to buy my phone, then I'll be able to produce less. But now when my phone can be sold anywhere on the globe, in any country, I will have more buyers. So my market becomes wide. So any developing country, if can sell more outside, will definitely get benefited with this globalization. And the limitations are, whatever was planned and designed and thought that globalization will make huge impact or will magic our economy, such expected results could not come. Why? Because globalization, we took it the other way. We increased our imports. We started buying all imported goods and we cannot export more. Our export is very less. So this is the basic reason why there is unexpected result of this globalization. So it is our responsibility that the way we are fond of buying imported goods, we should also push our country's economy by exporting more goods. Large scale industries have acquired more benefit than the small scale business. the giants, they have got huge benefit of globalization, but small industries, cottage industries, they could not make so much money out of this globalization policy. They cannot export as much. However, it entirely depends upon an individual about how he takes his business. There are many businesses in India that they are not doing it. They are not selling their goods in India. They are just exporting. So the goal has to be more exports. So students, this is all about globalization. Now there is one body called WTO, World Trade Organization, who is helping all the countries to smoothly go with this globalization policy, which will be a part of the next class. See you then. Bye-bye.